Good morning, comrades. I'd like to start by paying tribute to our Potong Pasir comrades who fought election after election, defeat after defeat for 27 years. These bitter experiences did not destroy us. Instead, they made us become stronger, closer, and more determined. To illustrate, I'd like to share with you a true story. We have a long-serving and dedicated comrade, Mr. Ng Chong Kiat, who passed away last year. My activists and I visited him in hospital before he passed away. When we were there, Comrade Ng held me by the hands and told me, "Sito, I am sorry I cannot help you anymore, but you must promise me one thing. You must take back Potong Pasir." Now, for any man who is lying sick in his hospital bed, there are many things to think about. But for Comrade Ng, Potong Pasir was high up on his agenda list. To me, this is the never-say-die spirit of Potong Pasir. More importantly, this is the PAP spirit. Please now allow me to share with you some of our experiences at the last elections, some things we did right. First, our message. Any troop going to battle must be convinced what they are fighting for. In the run-up to the elections, we asked our activists, our residents, who are they fighting for? Some said they are fighting for the PAP. Some said they are fighting for Singapore. Others said they were fighting for me. I suppose everybody is correct, but at the end of the day, we managed to convince many of our activists and many of our residents that they are fighting for themselves. They are voting for themselves and their family members. Second, our strategy was correct. We had a think tank group. This group is very important. You see, when a candidate goes campaigning, it is like him stepping into the boxing ring. At the sound of the bell, ding-ding, he steps forward to throw his punches. The more punches he throws, the more shook he becomes. But that is when he can get carried away and make some mistakes. Therefore, the coach at the ringside is very important. And our coach is our think tank group who guided me throughout our campaign period. They told me what to say, what not to say, how to say it, including how to bow after I make my speech on nomination day. Third, our command and control was right. We had one commander, Comrade Chua Kien Ming, better known as Achua, in Potong Pasir, who led our troops in a disciplined manner. We had rehearsals for very simple tasks. For example, when we distributed our manifesto, we would quietly slip them under the doors of the individual families if they are not at home. We do not leave them in the letterboxes. But if the families are at home, then we would humbly present the documents to them with both hands and say, "Uncle, Auntie, this is our manifesto. We hope you can take a look." In addition, we were also fortunate to have with us an advisor who shared with us his wisdom and experience. Our advisor for the election was our former MP, Comrade S. Chandra Das, whom I had the pleasure of serving as Branch Secretary for many years. I would now like to share with you our road ahead for the next 5 years. And for that, I will speak in Mandarin. 5月份的大选已经结束了，但是对我们来说，这不是终点。 这是起点，我们深深的知道，为民谋福、改善波东巴西的居住环境，是我们的使命与承诺。但是未来五年的路，我们该怎么走呢？首先，我们会以有限的资源和一颗真诚的心，脚踏实地， 一步一步的去推展所有大大小小的发展计划，去实现与完成我们在大选所许下的诺言。我们在这五年内完成了许多的硬件设备项目，是否能确保我们在下一届的大选能得到更多的支持票呢？我们觉得这是不足的，为什么？ 因为有一部分的选民会认为这是理所当然的，这是我们应该做的，这是我们的承诺。其实这也是没错的。因此，在大选时，硬件是不足的，需要更多的新建。新建又是什么呢？新建是人与人之间的联系与沟通，就是无限关怀。 处处的关心，只有与我们与居民沟通、联系、交流、细听、帮忙、感动，才能得到他们的信任与支持。所以说，得民心者得天下，这一点是我们深深体会到，也应该做到的。 我们成功的夺回了阔别27年的波东巴西是好事，但选民对我们的期望也相对的提高了，要求也多了。一部分的选民认为毕业必胜了，我们会要风得风，要雨得雨。可是我们不是有求必应的超人。 当然，我们会向政府申请更多的资源，为广大的居民福利，为他们打造一个更美好、更温馨的家园。大选时有超过一半的选民给予我们支持与信任，这是一股很大的推动力，我们会非常珍惜它。我们深深的体会到与居民的联系是非常重要的。 我们会把这联系根深蒂固的培养下去，但是我们并没有忘记另外一半没有支持我们的选民。我们将以事实来证明，我们是真心的为人民服务，我们确确实实的是在为波东巴西三代居民造福。我们将争取以改变这些人对我们的误解，要把。 对我们的怀疑、改成对我们的信任与支持。在此，我向波东巴西居民呼吁：同心，让我们看得更远；同步，让我们走得更近。波东巴西团队的奋斗精神，屡败屡战。 永不言败，胜不骄，败不馁。这使到我们敢断言，我们不是只要胜一届的大选，而是要把这千辛万苦攻下来的选区，永远的保存下去。谢谢。